Hey everyone, this is a quick setup video on how to install fabric mods, as many people have been struggling, and specifically the Litematica mod. So once you've installed the fabric client, as I've showed before, on the official Minecraft launcher, you'd have to make a new profile. So new, here, the latest fabric, name it whatever you want, and if you want to add your settings, go ahead. Just click create and you get a new one like this. I've already made mine. So you need to at least run the game once for the mods folder to show up. So if you press Windows R and percent app delta percent dot Minecraft and your mods, you need to run the fabric client at least once for this to show up. And inside, if you've done it like mine, it would only be the fabric API in order for fabric to work, right? So that's done. Now we're gonna be installing Litematica, which just seems to be the problem. So here, 1.16.5, which is the latest version as of recording. I'll put this in the description, and we're just gonna be installing this latest version. Okay, we can keep this. And another mod, you can install as mod menu to see the mods and if they're working or not. 1.16.5 as well. Downloading the latest one. Okay, we'll keep that. So in your mods folder, if you go over to your downloads, Litematica and mod menu, just drag them to your mods and just launch your game. Oh, another mod I forgot about. It's a dependency for the Litematica. So if you go back, right here, Litematica also requires the malib library mod. We're just gonna click on here and download the latest one for your version, 1.16.5, and we'll also be moving this to our mods folder. Here it is, drag it in, and now it should run. Okay, so the first thing you'll notice, new menu, the mods menu would come up. So if you click there, we'd see it here. So the mod menu, here we'll see if our mods are working and configure the settings. Mod menu works, and Litematica, it is working, and we can see. Here it is, configure. Okay, so if we can go into a random world, and I'll show you how to quickly configure Litematica. Okay, so, sorry, I'm gonna turn down my distance. So once you're in, the default key for Litematica is M. So when you press M, this should appear and you've got the schematic placement. I won't be showing on how you use everything here. I'll link below a good guide by Logical Geek Boy, which you can learn on how to use this, create schematics, and send them to other people and configure all the settings. Now, if you want to import a schematic from another person, for example, let's say here, we'll go to the SciCraft Discord, and we'll take a world and Litematics. Let's say I'll take this. Okay, I'm gonna download this schematic. So we'll go back to our .minecraft, and then here, you'd have to run Litematica at least once to get the schematics folder. So double click it and your schematics would be here. So these are the schematics I have, and the one I just downloaded, beacon range is 1.12. I'll just drag it in, and here, beacon range is 1.12, load schematic, and Yep. You can see it shows up as it should. Hopefully that clears up any confusions about the Litematica mod and fabric. And yeah.